Hey guys, it's me Sam, and today I'm doing a really special makeup request that has come from one of my beautiful and long-running subscribers. Her name is Lady Slaughter. I know her as Claire, and I consider her a very dear friend of mine. And I know that her birthday is coming up, and for her birthday she has asked me to do not just one request, but two requests. And today I'm going to do the first of the requests, which is a makeup tutorial, as I said at the beginning. And basically what she wants me to do is create a medieval styled bridesmaid look using the colours purple and gold. I'm going to start off by priming my face, and I'm going to be using Avon's new Skin Transforming Primer. Reason why I'm applying primer is because, well, it's going to be a long day and you want your makeup to stay put, and it doesn't really matter what primer you use, they're all created to do the same job. So apply that where you need it. Next, I'm going to apply a light-based foundation from Avon's New Skin Transforming range. This has got SPF 15 as well, and it's in the shade Ivory. I'm just going to apply that, as you can see, using the foundation brush. Gives a really nice coverage without being too heavy. Make sure you blend it in. Do not want any tide lines on a special day. Plus, luckily, she's pale like me, so hopefully, the colours I am using on myself will look just as good on Claire. Just to help conceal any bags under the eyes you might have, just apply a little bit of concealer. I'm using Avon's new Skin Transforming Concealer in Fair. And just pat that in using your fingertip. I'm just going to set that now using a loose powder. I'm using Avon's Ideal Flawless Loose Powder, which is in the shade Fair. But I still see a bit of an orangey tint to it, so I'm not going to use that much. I'm just basically just going to use it to set. So I'm going to use a nice soft fan brush. I'm just going to sweep that over the areas I want it to set. Right, I'm going to start on my eyes next, and I'm going to begin by priming them, and I'm using Avon's eyeshadow primer, which unfortunately I think has been discontinued. Silly Avon, what are you like? I love this primer. I've had nothing but great comments concerning it from other people that also love this. I'm now going to take a light plum eyeshadow, and I'm going to apply that to the outer 3/4 of the eyelid, and I'm going to blend it very softly into the crease line. I'm using Avon's 8-in-1 eyeshadow palette in Smoky Eyes, and the shade I'm going to use is this one here. Using the same palettes, I am now going to take this darker plum. I'm going to blend that very thinly into the crease and the outer V, and then I'm going to bring the colour underneath the lower lash line. Right, I'm just going to highlight my brow bone. I'm using Avon's Colour Trend Highlighter, which is called Halo. And I'm just going to blend that in underneath my brows. While I'm at it, I might as well highlight my cheekbone as well. Saves on time. Okay, I'm now going to take a gold eyeshadow and I'm going to apply that to the inner eyelid. And I'm going to use Avon's 24K Eyeshadow Quad in Gleam of Gold. And as you can see at the top, there is the gold eyeshadow that I'm going to be using. A faux clair wants to keep the focus on the bride. She still needs to stand out herself and look good. So to emphasise the eyes a little bit more, I'm just going to line the upper lash line with a black eyeliner. I'm using Avon's Always On Point eyeliner in black. For the eyes, I'm going to go for a couple of coats of black mascara, and today I'm using Avon's Super Shop Max mascara in black. And the reason why I'm using this is because I still think there needs to be some emphasis to Claire's eyes on that day. So to open them up, go for something like this. Right, for the rest of the face, I'm going to suggest a medium pink blush for your cheeks. I'm using this one from Avon's Ideal Luminous range. It's called Revitalized. It's actually a highlighter. Please excuse Madam for laughing her head off in the background. She's watching Big Brother. So I'm just going to sweep that along my cheekbone. Remember to smile because it will help pronounce your cheekbone so you can see what you're doing. Right, for the lips, I've decided a nice light mauve shade of a lipstick. I'm using this one from Avon. It's called Majestic Mauve. And it's from the Ruby Rich range. So it's got rubies in it. I'm going to apply it straight from the bullet. And there we go, that's my bridesmaid look that I was asked to create for my gorgeous friend Lady Slaughter. Done and dusted, so that's the first of my requests done for you, my darling. And now I shall proceed into letting you all know what the second request will be. Some of you may already know this about me, but some of you aren't going to. Not only do I love makeup and beauty and Jack cars and this, that, and the other, I love ghosts. I have been writing my own book now for many years. It's still nowhere near complete. And what Claire would like me to do is a ghost story. So the next time you see me, it may not be me. It may be my friend, or should I say friend? No, my biatch, because I keep her in a cage, you see. She's dangerous. Yes. Ladies and gentlemen, Lady Gothica will be featuring. Oh dear. Anyway, that is it for now. So thank you once again to Claire for asking me to do this for her. I hope she's happy with this. She might need to tone it down, maybe, I don't know. But I think it will look really, really nice on her, and I hope she has a wonderful day no matter what. But to help her out, I'm gonna stick me posting pictures up at the end as per usual. And with that, I better go and here they come. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you all soon. Until then, bye for now.